हेलो गाइस, वेलकम टू गेट फॉर गीक्स। सो इन टुडेज़ वीडियो वील बी सॉल्विंग अ गेट प्रीवियस ईयर क्वेश्चन ऑन द टॉपिक रिड्यूसिबिलिटी। इट वॉज केम इन 2005 एंड इट इज़ अ वेरी गुड क्वेश्चन। सो एज इन माई प्रीवियस वीडियो आई एक्सप्लेन द कंसेप्ट ऑफ रिड्यूसिबिलिटी विद द ट्रिकी पॉजिटिव एंड नेगेटिव थिंग। इफ़ यू हैवन वॉच द वीडियो देन क्लिक ऑन द आई बटन एंड वॉच द वीडियो। सो एज इन द प्रीवियस video I explain this concept of positive and negative thing. If p1 is decidable, these four cases were explained, and on the basis of these four cases you will be able to solve all the question. So let's solve this question. Now in this question it is given that there are three decision problem, p1, p2 and p3. It is known that p1 is decidable. First thing, it is given that p1 is decidable and p2 is undecidable. Okay, now we have to select the correct option from the given options. Now in the option A, it is given that if P1 is reducible to P3, if P1 is reducible to P3, then will P3 be decidable or what? So we have to test whether it is true or not. So consider that P1 is reducible to P3, and we are given two statements in the question. First is P1 is decidable. Now as I told you in my previous video that this will pass negativity to P3, negativity and positivity. So decidable is a positive thing, hence if P1 is decidable, P3 can be decidable or undecidable. And what about P2? There is no relation of P2 in this reducibility, hence for P3 we cannot predict anything whether it will be decidable or undecidable. For option B, it is given that P3 is reducible to P2. P3 is reducible to P2, and about P2 it is given that P2 is undecidable. Now P2 will pass positivity towards P3. As undecidability is a negative thing, similarly we cannot say anything about P3 whether it will be decidable or undecidable. Hence this option is also not correct. In the third option, it is given that P2 is reducible to P3. P2 is reducible to P3 and P2 is undecidable. P2 is undecidable. Now it is negative, that is it is undecidable, and it will pass negativity towards P3. Hence if it is undecidable, then P3 will also be undecidable. It will also be undecidable as it will pass negativity. Hence the option C, which is saying P3 is undecidable if P2 is reducible to P3, is absolutely the correct option. Now check the D option. It is given that P3 is reducible to P2's complement. Now P2 is undecidable, and complement of an undecidable problem is an undecidable problem. Hence P3 is reducible to P2's complement, and complement of an undecidable problem is an undecidable problem. Hence P3 is reducible to P2's complement. P2's complement is undecidable and it will pass positivity towards P3. Hence we cannot say anything about P3 whether it will be decidable or undecidable. Hence we have only one correct option, which is C. See, as it was multiple choice question, there is only one answer exists. If it was multiple select question, if multiple answer was possible for this question, then all the options can be correct, as problems can be decidable as well as undecidable. Hence we cannot say that this is 100% wrong. But if there exists only one answer to select, then absolutely correct answer will be C. Okay, now discuss one more question, very good question based on reducibility but in context of languages. So it is given that L1 is one language and L2 is another language, and L1 is reducible to L2. If L1 is reducible to L2, then L1 is a smaller set of languages and L2 is larger set of languages, as I told in my previous video. Now consider option A. Here I have also drawn the hierarchy of all the languages we have. It is given that L1 is regular. If L1 is regular, then L2 is recursively enumerable language. considering the fact that L1 is reducible to L2. So this is a possibility, because if L1 is a regular language, then L2, as it is a bigger set, is possible to be recursively enumerable. Hence, this is a correct option or possible option. Second option is L1 is recursively enumerable. L1 is here, and L2 is not recursively enumerable. This is also correct, because the set of not recursive enumerable is bigger than or larger than recursively enumerable set, and this is also a possibility. Now the third option is, it is given that L1 is not recursively enumerable. L1 is the last set possible. Now L2 should be larger than this, but in the option it is given that if L1 is not recursively enumerable, then L2 will be recursively enumerable, which is not at all possible. L2 cannot be a set smaller than L1 in hierarchy. Hence, this is not a possibility. Also, if any language is not recursively enumerable, then it is not possible that it will be recursively enumerable, because this is the portion where the language is not recursively enumerable. Now the fourth option is, it is given that L1 is recursively enumerable but not recursive. Recursively enumerable but not recursive means this part only, this concentric part, not the inside part. If L1 lies here, then L2 is recursively enumerable. This is also a possibility, because L2 and L1 both will lie inside this. Either L1 will be smaller than L2, or L1 can be equal to L2 if this part is null. Hence, this is also a possibility. So, except option C, all the options are possible if L1 is reducible to L2. I hope you all like the videos and the concept I have explained in this video. If you haven't watched the previous video in which I explained the concept of reducibility very thoroughly, please do watch it, and hit the like and subscribe button. Thank you.